So we are starting today at Riverside Garden Park Hawley, which is a lovely little park, albeit right next to Gatwick Airport. But that's not where the interesting part of the walk starts, so I think we will probably start off with a little montage. This feels like a staff path. It is a public footpath. That side of the roundabout is where we're heading for. We've got a little bit roundabout to get to it, but we'll be there in a minute, and that's where the interesting bit starts. Right, now this is where it starts getting interesting. We've left all the staff walking along the footpath over there that goes up towards the car parking. We've left all them to go on their way. And we've crossed over here to this finger post, which says that there is definitely a public footpath here. It is part of the Sussex border path, but we're not entirely sure where this footpath actually is. So that's today's challenge. Is to discover where this footpath in the middle of Gatwick Airport actually is. I had a look on Street View, and it looks like it's actually probably more travelled than I thought. I bought secateurs to help, and on Street View that was not obvious. Some people have walked up round here, but that doesn't go anywhere. So let's go explore a footpath less travelled. Although more travelled than I thought. So at this point, I should probably explain where this all began. While planning a series of walks on the Reigate and Batstead Millennium Trail, I noticed this strange path around the airport, which seemed to lead to nowhere. Tracing it back, it continued right round to this roundabout in the middle of the airport. But on Google Street View, or on a quick drive around the roundabout, I could not make out where the footpath was at all. So I decided to make exploring it into a project. As we've just seen, the entrance to the footpath turned out to be clearly obvious. Now whether that's down to weather, maintenance, usage of the path or what, I don't know. But now we're here, let's continue to explore this footpath and see what we can find. We're stuck here between a relatively main road on that side. And up that side, up that hill, is some staff car parking and a Premier Inn. And down here we reach a Travelodge. But in a bit we will come across the River Mole and the rest of this footpath follows along the route of the River Mole. So it should be a relatively nice walk, and we also lose the main road once we get to the Travelodge. So here's the access to the Travelodge, and the footpath continues down there. It looks like we're maybe getting a little bit more wild exploring as we start going down here. So let's go explore. This is a bit more what I was expecting of the other footpath, but I wonder if that one's regularly used to get between the Travelodge and the terminals. It's surprisingly quiet down here for being next to an airport. Part of that maybe because this is summer autumn 2021 when we're just coming out of the pandemic, but I wonder even with a full complement of flights if it's still this nice and quiet down here. River is somewhere over there. I think we come back to it in a little later on the walk. We'll come right up next to it. I think that's the airport's stormwater facility for managing floods. So this bridge here is a staff access to the airport, and just at the top of it there are also some signs by some houses that mention parking only for local dog walkers. So I have a suspicion that the vast majority of people who use this footpath are going to be exactly that, local dog walkers. There's a couple of points where the footpath links up with the roads above, and that's probably the most used. And then I'll explain a bit more when we get to the last one of those. There have definitely been horses down here as well. Got some all sorts of marks in this dry mud actually. You've got animal tracks there. Not that horses aren't animals. Hoof prints, people prints. Bit of everything. And a load of fresh mud for us to make our prints in. That's quite pretty. Sort of wide bit. Oh, I see a fish. I have no idea whether that'll show up in the video or not. There's a fish just in the middle there. See it?
Yes.
We found a lesser spotted person on the same route as us. No idea if she has a dog yet or not. And also the airport boundary road. Every time we pass another entrance or exit way up to the road, the amount the footpath is used feels like it changes. Either that or we're just following interesting different bits of footpath. Who knows? It's starting to look a bit more wetlandy out here and a bit less grasslandy. I think just over here is some closed long stay parking. Some off sites, just long stay parking. Yes, it's an awful lot of very closed looking car park. Ah, so up there, that gate, is where the footpath joins in with the driveway of a nursery and goes up to the main road.
Yeah.
We're going to carry on down this way where these other dog walkers are going. So we've gone past another entrance up to the road and the feel of the footpath has changed yet again. We now seem to be up on a little ridge above the river. And the brambles are closing in again. Ooh, apples of some sort. Unfortunately, I'm no, what's the word? Botanist?
Fruitist.
No atomic shrimp. Oh, there's a little bench where you can sit and look at some woods or the dog poop hanging on a tree. Lovely. I assume the river is down there in amongst all those weed. Oh, it's down here. Under a load of lily pads. Another bench. It's obviously still actively walked around here. There's people who put benches. But I suppose it is the Sussex border path, so it is an actual path. Oh, I see, the Sussex border path goes off that way. I wonder if they had to re-divert it or something when the when it got cut off by the runway. Apparently this is the Northwest Zone Biodiversity Area. Brocklywood and Povey Cross. Where we're going is apparently not a footpath, but we're going to do it anyway. According to that sign, anyway. Found a road again. This is looking interesting down here now. A little bit. It's definitely a footpath because there's a dog waste bin there. But now we've passed the last exit point up to the road. There's only one way to go. That's the last exit point up to the road. There's only one way to go now. And it's straight on. So we'll see how it pans out. Hello. Sorry. Very pretty. The river's really becoming a trickle here, if that is the actual river. No, this was a rivulet. Here is the river. I see no fish. The trees here appear to have all been planted in nice neat rows. They must have been planted deliberately, because that doesn't really happen in nature. It's like finding hidden worlds. the sad old planes to the modern running ones. They've fenced in the top of the river here, presumably to stop anyone from trying to sneak into the airport up the river. We've got airport boundary along that edge of the river. Airport boundary here. Airport boundary over here. And actually a bit of airport boundary behind us. We're sort of on a little spit of land that's enclaved in Gatwick Airport. I'll show you it on a map. Disturbing all the birdies. Sorry, birdies. Okay, we really have now found the footpath less travelled. This is just coming up on the very end of this dead-end public footpath. We saw a nice local woman further back who did walk up to the corner of the airport fence, had a look at the planes and walked back. But I get a feeling from this footpath here that doesn't really exist. We've got a little bit of space between the airport fence on the right, and there's a little wire fence just in the hidden in the wood in the things to our left. We've got this tiny little bit of area we can use, and you get the feeling that the airport authorities probably rather people didn't. But it's a public footpath, so we're going to be belligerently British, and we're going to use this public footpath, and we're going right down to the end and then turn around and come back, so there's no other option. But yeah, quite a good view of some taxi operations on the runway, if you can see through the fence with the camera. Right, we're just going to round the corner of this fence here, and then we reach the point where the river's down there, and this public footpath, part of the Sussex border path, runs round here, but then just ends. On the map, it's been cut off by the runway, and that's it. The river goes through its tunnel under the airport, under the runway, and with that corner of fence over there, the footpath ends. No other way through, no other way around, nothing else you can do. Apart from, turn around and head back again.
Thank you for watching all the way to the end, and we hope you enjoyed this walk as much as we did. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up and let us know any thoughts or suggestions in the comments. We hope to see you next time, and in the meantime, get out and about and enjoy the great outdoors.